Hello and welcome to episode 7 of the Car Diaries, and what could be mistaken for Italy. We're experiencing some absolutely glorious sunshine here in Scotland, so we thought what better weather than to take out the brand new Ferrari 488 Pista, welcoming our very first Italian stallion to the channel and see what this new beast is all about. So the 488 Pista, as many of you know, based on the standard Ferrari 488 model. Now this car is somewhat different in almost every single way, so we're going to be taking a little look into that and find out a little bit more about this car. So let's take a little look at the exterior of this car and find out what it's all about. So obviously based on the standard 488, the 488 Pista is a lightweight version of the car. It's shaved off more than 85 kilos in weight, and it's also increased power right up now to 720 horsepower or 710 brake horsepower if you're not doing the metric scale. Now, as we come round the car, you'll see the aero is a lot more aggressive as well. We've also got a lot of active aero going on in the car, which I'll talk a little bit more about once we're behind the wheel of the car and how that actually helps to put the power down. Massive ceramic discs, as you would expect, with plenty of stopping power. The car's now sitting on Michelin tyres, which are the standard tyres on the 488 Pista. I must admit, on a day like today, where it's 20 degrees Celsius, they work really, really well, build up heat quite quickly, and feel very, very sticky. Now, I've heard on track and things like that, they're not the best tyre. You might need to go for more of a semi-slick, but obviously that's something that can be easily changed. I think for a road tyre, that's pretty much the perfect compound, and the car seems to break traction very, very slightly, only in the lower end, 0 to 60, once you get any sort of momentum built up, it just grips for life. It's absolutely unbelievable. Now, as we work our way around, this car is a massive, massive specification. It's got almost every conceivable carbon fibre goodie specified on it. So you'll see we've got the carbon side skirt, we've got the carbon rear intake, carbon engine bay, carbon rear diffuser section. It's got pretty much every box. All the interior has also been finished in matte carbon, which we'll take a look at in a second, which is really nice. Now, a really neat thing Ferrari do is with your options, they pop a little list under the front boot of the car, and that shows you every single option in the car, which when it comes to resale, I suppose is quite a nice thing. People aren't fiddling through trying to find invoices and things like that. So if you didn't know that already, you find all the options under the boot of a Ferrari. Now, as we come round to the rear of the car, as you can see, I'm smiling just looking at the rear. One of the coolest looking rear ends of any car in the market at the moment, as far as I am concerned. It looks absolutely mega. When you see it in person, it's a lot wider than you would expect. We've got the black exhaust tip specified in the car, and you can see the full carbon fibre lower bumper and diffuser section there, which also looks insane. I'm sure you've seen the number plate in the car as well, which is pretty cool, sitting low, works really nicely. And yeah, I think it pretty much sums that car up in one. So as we move round, I'll pop the engine bay to let you have a little look at that. Full carbon engine bay, you can see the 488 Pista logo there. Obviously all handcrafted by Ferrari, and this is still very, very much a Ferrari. A lot of friends have been asking, how's it compare to something like a 458 Speciale? Now, Speciale being the natural aspirated version, obviously has a glorious soundtrack. This thing, I didn't know what to expect. Having driven it for about an hour already, and as you'll see in a few moments, this thing sounds just as good. The turbochargers add a whole lot to the driving experience. You hear them whooshing and spooling up, and every time you lift off the throttle, there's an insane amount of noise in the cabin. So yeah, it'll still very much put a smile on your face. So stepping inside the 488 Pista, and it's as you would expect, a sumptuous interior coated in Alcantara and raw carbon fibre. Now, there's no leather at all in the cabin, as leather's that little bit heavier than Alcantara, and Ferrari did their very best to shave off as much weight as they could with the Pista version of this car. Now, Pista in Italian actually means track, so this is very much the track 488. We're not going to be taking it on track today, but we'll be taking it on some proper twisty little B roads. As you know, my favourite type of road, and we'll see what this car is all about, and we'll make sure we get it into race mode as well, just to see what the full throttle response is all like. So welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to behind the wheel of the new Ferrari 488 Pista. Now, as I mentioned earlier on in the video, Pista in Italian literally means track, so this is a car designed for the track. But what we're going to do is take it on this glorious day. It's 25 degrees, I'm absolutely sweltering. The Alcantara seat seemed to be sticking to me. But we're going to take it for a bit of a, run on some nice B roads. We're out towards Loch Lomond in Scotland, some of the best driving roads in the world. So we're going to see if this track car is any good on the road. So let's see what it's all about. And hopefully this car should be quite something. So we're coming into a national speed limit zone. So what I'm going to do is flick this manifold switch. So we've still got the manifold switch in the new 488. I love the manifold switch. I know a lot of people out there have said, oh, it's been on the go for too long and Ferrari need to refresh the interiors and things, but I don't think so. I love it. I think it's very functional. So flick it into race, bang down a couple of gears, use these paddles, dual clutch gearbox, which is tremendous. And as soon as you get in the power, it's just instant. The amazing thing about the car is obviously it is turbocharged, which you get that little inclination that it's turbocharged every now and then when there's just a sudden surge of power. However, I must say the torque curve and things in the car feels more like a naturally aspirated car. It doesn't feel particularly turbocharged. And you can rev right up to the red line, which is 8,000 RPM. And even at 8,000 RPM, the car is still pulling. Whereas the standard 488 GTB, you felt that when it got to 6.5 to 8,000 RPM, it was almost giving up a little bit. You had to bang up into the next gear. This is where this Pista version feels completely different. The question a lot of friends were asking is, how does this compare to the 458 Speciale in terms of noise? So as you'll know, the 458 Speciale has a 4.5 litre naturally aspirated V8, hence this tremendous soundtrack. Now with the 488, Ferrari obviously downsized to a 3.9 litre V8, but they then twin turbocharged it. Now the engine in this Pista is actually the engine from the 488 challenge car, or a derivative, as opposed to the engine from the 488 GTB. So it's a far more race-derived engine. Vocally, the cars are a lot noisier, as it's got an Inconel exhaust system, which is technology used in spacecraft, actually. And it essentially allows the exhaust to be a lot more free and also releases a lot more of the noise in the soundtrack. So in terms of theta, the car's a good bit noisier than a 488 GTB. You've got some serious induction noise, and every time you lift off the throttle as well, there's some serious noise from the outlet valve, which sounds absolutely tremendous. So all in all, the noise has not disappointed me, even in the slightest. So for anyone out there that's watching the video thinking, oh, it sounds quite muted, it sounds quite quiet, I can assure you, when you're behind the wheel of this thing, it definitely doesn't sound quiet in the slightest. Which again, just to prove the point, if I'm just chatting just now, drop it down a couple of cogs, and all you can hear is that tremendous engine. I have to shout when I'm... And I don't know if the mic will pick up that turbo whoosh, but I can assure you, it honestly sounds absolutely ridiculous. Flick it back into sport, back into auto, get up into seventh gear. And Matt and myself were saying earlier when we were cruising in the motorway out to Loch Lomond, it's actually a really, really nice cabin. For being the racing version, the rawest version of the 488, it's actually very, very usable. You've got a button here which you can press for the suspension, which puts the car in bumpy road mode, as Ferrari call it, which gives you a nice compliant suspension. And genuinely, you really don't have to raise your voice. The seats are perfectly comfortable. These are carbon fibre backed race seats. They're not full on buckets, but they're more than supportive enough in the twisties, and also very, very comfortable when you're just cruising around as well. So actually, the Pista, as far as I'm concerned, is very much still a road car. Yeah, it was pretty much born and bred in the track, and it's a race-derived engine in the car, but it's still very much perfect road car, albeit it is stupidly, stupidly quick. As you can probably tell from my expression and also how aggressive the gear changes are, this thing is blisteringly quick. I mean, let's do it again, second gear. The G-forces that pin you back in your seat honestly, this thing is unreal. Just to put it in perspective, this car does 0 to 124 miles per hour, which is 200 kilometers an hour, in just 7.5 seconds. The McLaren 675LT, which is one of the quickest cars I've ever driven as well, does it in 7.9 seconds. This is a full 0.4 seconds quicker to 124 miles an hour than the McLaren 675LT. This thing is insanely quick. But as I say, that's the difficulty, I suppose, is really being able to utilise all that power. You can't, you just can't do it on British roads. But I will say, whatever power you do get to use will be sure to put a massive, massive grin on your face. The soundtrack's ridiculous, the brakes in this thing, the ceramics, as you'd expect, they kind of have to be good with that amount of power, are also tremendous. And the best part for me is the chassis. The chassis in this thing is absolutely tremendous. I mean, it's now 21 degrees Celsius outside. We were going around some really nice wee twisties at a decent pace, and it just sticks to the roads like glue. The car remains incredibly flat, and albeit it is a big wide car, it genuinely feels almost as nimble in the road as my Lotus. I mean, the steering is just, you point it exactly where you want to go, and it goes, and you really don't have to move it that much. Yet when you're cruising at motorway speed, it genuinely doesn't feel too quick, whereas the Lotus does. The Lotus can dart around the motorway a little bit with the slightest movement of the steering wheel. This doesn't seem to. Yet when you come onto twisty roads, it's as accurate and precise as you'd ever want it to be. And you can see exactly with your front haunches there where your front wheels are as well, so you can place it beautifully on the road. So my final thoughts on the Ferrari 488 Pista. For me, this is an absolute dream machine. It's a car I didn't imagine I was going to drive anytime soon. And words cannot describe how much this car puts a smile on my face. It's as good, if not better, than the Speciale. It definitely doesn't disappoint in the sound department. And for anyone that's in the fortunate position out there being able to potentially look at one and buy one, go drive it, do it. Oh my God, put your money where your mouth is. This thing is an absolute beast. I hope you've enjoyed this latest episode of the Car Diaries. We very much look forward to seeing you in the next episode. And I want to leave you with some nice driving scenes for you to enjoy the car in all its glory in the Scottish Highlands around Loch Lomond. And thank you once again for watching.
But nothing you've been dropping yet astonishes. Yeah. Next shit I'm about to say is obvious, but criticism's worth some more than compliments. Yeah. Yeah. We're living at a different speed, trying to sprout a money tree. We started out with just a seed.